LeBron and the Lakers clinched the number one seed in the West earlier this week. Something LeBron said that most people thought he couldn't do, but he has proved his doubters wrong. And joining us now is the legendary Michael Rapaport, who might have a few things to say about it. Mike, so good to have you. How much do you believe in the Lakers to win it all?
All right, well, before we get to that, I just want to tell you guys, through the last 4.5 months, in all seriousness, Skip, Shannon, Jenny, when there's been sports to talk about, when there's been no sports to talk about, when it's been fear, when we've been all the things that we've dealt with, having you guys in the morning has been a true pleasure and a true joy. I say that as a fan. I'm sure I'm not the only fan of the show that wanted to just express that. You guys have been great throughout all the time. Now we have sports. We're done with the sweet nothings. Okay. I hope you got some rest, both you guys. Okay. But I mean that in all sincerity, Shannon, congratulations. Your team won, clinched the number one spot in the West, but this is Los Angeles. It's all about jewelry. It's all about rings and things. I've never met a more entitled fan base in my home away from home. I love Los Angeles. I love Los Angeles, but you know the Clippers are coming, okay? This is a young man's bubble. It's a long, long, winding bubble, okay? And do you really think that the Henny God, J.R. Smith, and Dion Waiters, and little Alex Caruso, don't they have a barbershop? He's got to commit. Don't they have a barbershop in that bubble?
Do you really think?
I mean, just shave it all off, Alex. It's cute. It's spotty. But it's time to, it's like, shave the whole thing off. You look nuts. And the headband just accentuates it. Do you really think little Alex Caruso, Dion Waiters, and J.R. Smith are going to be able to get it done? I mean, you guys are going to be dealing with the Blazers in the first round. That's going to be tough. I think the Lakers will get past them. But I don't even think the Los Angeles Lakers are going to get to the finals. You got Denver. You got Houston. And God forbid you actually do get to the finals. We all saw that the Toronto Raptors have that Canadian secret sauce, which is to just throw double teams at the guy that LeBron James, he's just, please stay healthy. Please stay focused. Please don't get tired, because when they run those double teams at your guy, Anthony Davis, who should be the MVP of the league, they're in big trouble. That Canadian secret sauce. So, listen, can I say right now, will they make it out of the West? I'm not sure, but they're not winning a championship. It's a long and winding bubble. And I can't wait, Shannon. Oh, I can't wait. I can't wait.
You keep telling me what you say, it's a young man's bubble. Well, we've already seen somebody from your team that's a relatively young man, and he had to make a pit stop. He went and got a bucket of lemon pepper wings. Mm. How you like
sweet
that?
Sweet sauce, Lou?
Yeah. Oh, your lemon pepper Lou. Mm. But here's the thing, though. He went for takeout. But what he wanted to take out is not available until 2 a.m. But that's neither here nor there, Michael Rapaport. Look, the thing is, we've struggled shooting the three ball. We're better than what we've shown shooting the three ball. I'm not saying we're a 40% shooting three team. But LeBron James right now is just finding his rhythm. We see we got AD. Y'all got no answer. Nobody has an answer for Anthony Davis. You know that. I know that. The teams that are in the bubble that's going to make the playoffs, they know that. And guess what happens come playoff time? That guy, 2-3, turns into a different animal. You don't like that. You don't like that.
I don't like it, and I know he's coming. And let me tell you something. The one person I wasn't worried about getting sick through this whole time, it's two people, Tom Brady and LeBron James. Those guys will literally spit out any disease. They're freaks. He's been focused. He's got the team playing together, and it's great. But, Shannon, you've seen this before. You have seen this before. Every year this guy does it. He's great. Okay, he's fantastic, but he's not going to be able to do it. He's not going to be able to do it alone, and his supporting cast just won't get it done. I love Kyle Kuzma. We don't know what we're going to get from him. But do you really, really actually think the supporting cast, the best supporting actor in a movie, best supporting actress is such an important part of making a great film. You don't have that best supporting actor.
What is AD? What's a we got two leads. We ain't even got no supporting.
Exactly.
You got two leads. We got Denzel and Samuel Jackson. So that movie gonna carry itself.
Which one's Denzel?
Hey, don't worry about all that. See, you're trying to start dissension. That's what you're trying to do. We ain't gonna let you do it though.
Skip, jump in there. I know. Listen, I've been listening to you guys every day. It's been like my meditation. I know what you're going to say, Shannon. You know what the deal is. You know it's coming. You got Denver. You got Houston. You got Portland, who's going to put up a fight. They're getting their groove on right now. And then, God forbid, you make it to Canada.
Size 14.
It's over. It's gonna be a painful loss. And that mask, I'm gonna come to your house. I'm gonna burn that goat mask once and for all. We're gonna burn that. I don't care about pollution. We're gonna burn that thing once and for all.
So, Michael, you live much closer to downtown Los Angeles than I do. So the traffic must have been pretty bad near your house yesterday, because you know there was a victory parade in downtown LA because the Lakers won it all. They clinched the number one seed, and LeBron beat his chest after the game and said, "They said I couldn't do it in the West." You clinched the number one seed because Kawhi and Paul George didn't play together very much, and because Golden State is now Olden State. They're gone and forgotten. They're the worst team in basketball. Are you kidding? You would gloat over that, clinching the West?
Yes.
It's not over a ring. You were the grand marshal at the parade, right?
No.
How was it?
But
is
there
really
be
a parade?
No, but it will be, and you're not invited.
Oh, Shannon, there's not going to be a parade. I can tell from your spunk. I can tell from your fire. It's dimmed down. You know the inevitable is coming. You understand that it's coming. It's going to be such a devastating heartbreak. Everything that Laker fans have been through in the last 6 months, and the late great Kobe, even the late great Kobe playing for him, it's not going to be able to get it done. Two guys cannot win an NBA championship. The Toronto Raptors dismantled you guys the other day. They just throw the double teams.
Hold on. Did you not see what the Suns did to the Clippers? Did you just not see what we did to the Clippers? Did you not just see that?
Kawhi Leonard is getting into shape. Devin Booker made a great shot. He made a great shot. It was great defense, and he made a great – it's a great shot.
But let me ask you a question.
It's a 360 jump shot.
Time out. I'm trying to figure out, why is the game even close? Phoenix Suns, they only got invited to the bubble because Adam Silver, the commissioner, says, "I need you guys to get some conditioning for next year." He invited them.
No, they're three games behind the Grizz.
They're three games now.
They've won three in a row. They're the 3-0 team in the bubble.
They beat the Clippers.
They have a lot of young talent, and they're playing with nothing to lose. The Phoenix Suns are not bums. The Phoenix Suns have been on the rise all season. They have a lot of young talent. They've been building back. It's a great shot over great defense. He had two people's hands in his face. He made the shot. They should have beat them.
It's been
Kawhi, look at Kawhi did. He put up great numbers yesterday again. Okay, they won the game. Sweet Lou was his first game back. Patrick Beverly sat out most of the game. I mean, it's a great shot. What do you want?
Well, the ball was slippery. Lou had some lemon pepper still on his hand. But before I turn it over to Skip.
Wait, he's the stand-up comic.
Oh, my bad.
You got jokes.
My bad.
Mike, he's just beating that joke into the ground.
Mike, here we go. This has been a very bad week for Kawhi and Paul George. On the last shot, LeBron D'd him up at 35 in year 17. He made Kawhi give the ball up because he couldn't go anywhere, and he made Paul George hit the backboard. And then come back almost 5 days later, and Devin Buckets, hit a shot on both of them. But Paul George gives up more game-winning shots than anybody in the NBA history. Just look it up and see how many guys have hit game-winning shots over PG.
Oh, that
you are too old to be on Instagram. I'm sick and tired of you stealing your stuff all off of Instagram. He puts the hands in the face. Okay, the guy made the shot. Dame did the same thing. Ridiculous shot.
Well, he must have did it like this. He must have got his finger spread because the guy can show and see the basket because the ball going in the basket.
Mm.
And no player has benefited from the 4 months off more than Paul George. He looks unstoppable. He played great defense. Young Booker made a great shot. We move on. Okay, we move on. I'm glad you guys are peaking now. The Clippers are not peaking
right
now.
We're not peaking at all.
They're going up the hill. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. You guys came in, and you knew LeBron was going to do that. You came in. He's got the battery, and Anthony Davis is back. He's playing good. LeBron is playing as good as he could possibly play at this age, at this point in his career. And that's fantastic. But can he do it? We're talking about October. Okay, we're talking about Halloween masks and stuff, like Halloween fun, like, you know, dressing up. That's a long, long ways away, my friend. A long ways away. And you got a lot of people to go through in the West.
So, Michael, explain this to me. Anthony Davis, the co-star, what is he, the co-lead to this show? Yep. In four fourth quarters against the Clippers this year, he has attempted a grand total of 9 shots. He took 14 shots in the first quarter against Utah. It seems like in the big games with the brightest lights, including the fourth quarter of the Toronto game when he took only 1 shot, it seems like AD stands for all done. All done in the fourth quarter. Okay. Can you really lean on that guy with low winners intangibles that he brought from New Orleans to help you win a championship in Los Angeles? I don't think so.
I do.
I agree. What have we don't know what Anthony Davis is going to do when the sweat starts dripping and things get real. We haven't seen it. He may do one thing. He may not do another thing. And there's going to be plenty of situations that he's never been in. True. He's never been in these deep waters. We're talking about the Pacific Ocean.